Yeah, thank you all for joining in. Welcome to our Srimad Bhagavatam class. Today we are going to discuss about the chapter 16 of Canto 8. So last few days we are already discussing the chapter 16. We'll have a quick overview and also the following few verses from the chapter 16, which is titled as Executing the Payavrata, which is the process of worship. Before that, we'll be reciting Mangalacharna prayers. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Itinamine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine नामश्रेष्ठं मनुमपि सचिपुत्रमत्र स्वरूपं रूपं तस्याग्रजमुरुपुरी माधुरीं गोष्ठवाटीं राधाकुण्डं गिरिवरमहो राधिका माधवाश्यां प्राप्तो यस्य प्रतितकृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि कृष्णाधन्यमजानतक्षणमपि स्वप्नेऽपि विश्वेश्वरे तस्मिन् भक्तिमहैतु किं विदधतु हृत्काय वाग्भिः सदा श्रीलान् सद्गुणपुञ्जकेलिनिलयान् प्रेमावतारानहं वन्दे भागवतानि मामनुलवं मूर्ध्नानि प्रत्यक्षितौ आजानुलम्बितभुजौ कनकावदातौ संकीर्तनैकपितरौ कमलायताक्षौ विश्वंबरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणावतारौ जयतां सुरतौ पंगोर्मम मंदमतेर्गति मत्सर्वस्वपदाम्बोजौ राधा मदनमोहनौ नीलाचल निवासाया नित्याया परमात्मने बलभद्र सुभद्राभ्याम जगन्नाथाय ते नमः। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर 16 ऑफ कैंटो 8 व्हिच इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिंग पयोव्रत एंड सेटिंग द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस इज after the samudra manthana pastime, because demons got cheated and the demigods got the nectar, later demons were in Maros, and later with great force they try to attack again the demigods, and because demons, they were still following the orders, and the demons, they were respecting the brahmanas. For example, Bali Maharaj is following the orders of his master Shukracharya, and here on the other side, the demigods did not please the brahmanas sufficiently, that they did not get the sufficient power to face them. The demigods did not get sufficient power to face the demons. So in that sense, Bali Maharaj again entered the kingdom of Indra, and he took over the position of the three worlds. At that point, when Indra went to his guru Brihaspati, he suggested that, okay, the demons are having much more power as of now. You please take back a step and wait for the right time. And at that point, now we are in the context where Kashyapa Muni visits the ashrama of Aditi. So Kashyapa Muni has a few wives. Out of them, Aditi and Diti are there. The sons of Aditi are demigods and the sons of Diti are demons. So when Kashyapa Muni visits the ashrama of Aditi, so he sees her in morose condition. And at that point, Aditi laments for protection. So it is like after many, many years, Kashyapa Muni came out of his meditation and returned to the ashrama. So here we have few inquiries which Kashyapa Muni has asked Mother Aditi. So he asks, have you disobeyed the prescribed duties? So whatever the prescribed duties we have, we should follow. So our prescribed duties in this Kali Yuga is chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and following the four regulative principles, because that is what our gurus will be directing us to follow all through the life. So this is the important one where one should not disobey their prescribed duties. And he asks, any discrepancies in for following Dharma, Artha and Kama? So have you broken anywhere this following these three principles? And next is most important for the grihasthas. So have you failed in receiving the guests properly? Such homes are like holes of jackals. So he says, anyone who does not receive the guest properly, then his house is nothing but a place where jackal stays. That is how important one should give the importance to the guests. So if we see, there are many, many examples in the scriptures. Even in the war, when Kurukshetra was happening, so they do not fight morning to morning. So they just fight from sunrise to sunset. And after that, everyone are like, their family members. So Pandavas would go to the house of or to the place where Kauravas stay. At that point, they don't think that the Pandavas are enemies. So they welcome them, they give their seat, they offer all the respects. And even when we see Sudama going to the house of Lord Sri Krishna, so Krishna doesn't need to please anyone. But when Sudama comes there, Krishna himself welcomes him and washes his home. So that gives all of us examples on how to receive the guests properly. That is the most important one. And next he asks, did you fail to worship fire and brahmanas? And are your sons well? So these are the inquiries which Kashyapa Muni has made. For that, Aditi replies. So he says, no disturbances in the household life. Nothing has been neglected because you are my Swami. So I always remember you. So there is no disturbance in the household life. I am following properly everything. And she says, because you are Prajapati, you can fulfill all my desires. And she says, you are equal to both your sons, demons as well as demigods, just like the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But even he is inclined to devotees. So here she is saying indirectly, you should save our sons or you should restore their original positions. How she is saying? She is saying, you are like that Supreme Personality of Godhead who showers the blessings on everyone, but he reciprocates more to the devotees. So in the similar analogy, she is saying, he is inclined to devotees. So you should also incline to our sons, the demigods rather than demons. And next she says, we are deprived. So because demons overtook the heavenly planets, now Aditi says, we are deprived of our opulence, fame, beauty, residence. So they have been exiled from their place. At this condition, bestow the benediction by which we can regain what was lost. So she is asking a way that how now we can regain our original position. And here Kashyapa Muni advises Aditi to perform devotional service. To whom? To that Supreme Lord who is the cause of all causes. So hearing this, Kashyapa Muni was completely shocked and he is sympathetic. So now he says, how powerful is Maya? And he even gives example of this body, which is made of five elements. And the relationships between these bodies are illusion. And now he gives the advice saying, you engage in the devotional service to that Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, who can bestow all auspicious benedictions to everyone. So he's saying you perform devotional service to Lord Krishna. And that Lord bestows benediction on poor. If not devotional service, everything is useless. That is what he's saying. So he is the father of demigods as well as demons. He is the Prajapati. So that person is saying there is no other way to get out of all the miseries other than performing devotional service. So at this point, Madhavar Aditi asks, what is the perfect method by which that Supreme Personality of Godhead can be pleased and her sons can be saved? So when Mother Aditi asked Kashyap Muni this, what is that perfect method by which he can be pleased and we can regain our position? At this point, Kashyap Muni instructs the process of Payovrata. So we have already seen when and how this should be performed in the previous sessions. So on a high level, when it should be performed on the bright fortnight of month of Falguna, which falls in the February and March, and it should be for 12 days and it should end with Dwadashi. And how one should follow? One should observe the vow of subsisting only on milk for 12 days. So as we see, Payovrata, Payo means milk. So the austerity by with the ingredient of milk. And he says, one should worship the lotus-eyed Supreme Personality of Godhead with all devotion. So when we say devotion, it should be like, we should not expecting anything. So it should be like completely selfless devotion. And on the day of dark moon, one should smear the dirt on his body dug up by a boar and then bathe in the flowing river. So why earth and boar example was given? Because earth was raised, Mother Earth was raised by the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the form of boar. And that is what here he suggests the mantra while taking the bath in the river. So he says, O Mother Earth, you were raised by the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the form of a boar, Varaha. Because of your desiring to have a place to stay, I pray that you kindly vanquish all the reactions of the sinful life. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. So when Lord Varahamurti took the earth out of the ocean, which is deep inside, so that thing should be remembered while taking the bath in the river. So the Lord has saved, and to that particular Lord, I need to offer my respectful obeisances. And one should perform his daily scriptural duties. So here also it is mentioned about the importance of our scriptural duties to follow our sadhana and the prescribed regulative principles. So one should never give up their chanting and the four regulative principles. And the next is, with great attention, offer worship to the deity of Supreme Personality of Godhead and also to the altar, sun, water, fire, and spiritual master. So you should worship all these with great attention. And later, yesterday we have seen the prayers to that Supreme Personality of Godhead was described. How he is greatest of all, he is who lives in everyone's heart and who in whom everyone lives. So how he lives in everyone's heart? As Paramatma, he stays in everyone's heart. And how in whom everyone lives? So we all are part and parcels, and we are there in this universe, and all these universes culminate into Mahavishnu. So everyone goes and stays in him. And he is the witness of everything. He sits in our heart as Paramatma and he witnesses all our activities. And because he gives us minute independence to live ourselves, he does not interfere until and unless we surrender to him. And he is the supreme, all-pervading person. So to that person, to that Supreme Lord, I offer my respectful obeisances. And from here, we'll continue the today's session. The prayers continues. Om Agnati Miranda Signananjana Shalakaya Chakshuran Melitam Yena Tasmai Sri Guravena Kruti Vachalam Pangam Langayati Girim Yat Kripataham Vande Sri Gurum Tina Tarana. So here the prayers continue. Namah Shivaya Rudraya Namah Shakti Dharaya Cha Sarva Vidyadi Pataye Bhutanam Pataye Namaha. So I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, Lord Shiva or Rudra, who is the reservoir of all potencies, the reservoir of all knowledge and the master of everyone. So as we already understood that Lord Shiva is one of the expansions of Lord Vishnu. So when he expands himself into the Gunavataras, into three Gunas, so he expands as Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. So here we are offering respectful obeisances. So one who is performing the Payavrata should offer their respectful obeisances unto Lord Shiva, who is the reservoir of all potencies and all knowledge. Namo Hiranya Garbhaya Pranaya Jagadatmane Yogeshwarya Shariraya Namaste Yoga Hetave. I offer my respectful obeisances, Namo, who are situated as Hiranyagarbha. So Hiranyagarbha is attributed to Brahma as well as Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Brahma because he is the secondary creator, but here when it is referred, Acharyas has mentioned that he is Garbhodakshaya Vishnu from whom everything emanates. So Hiranya means gold. Garbha means womb. So that person whose womb is gold. So he is here. It is referred to Garbhodakshaya Vishnu, and from him, this material cosmic manifestation inside the universe takes place. And that Hiranyagarbha is the source of life, the super soul of every living entity, and your body is the source of opulence of all mystic power. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. So one should offer his respectful obeisances unto Lord Shiva. And again, one should offer the respectful obeisances unto Hiranyagarbha. And Namasta Adi Devaya Sakshi Bhutaya Te Namaha Narayanaya Rishaye Naraya Haraye Namaha. I offer my respectful obeisances unto you, who are the original personality of Godhead, the witness in everyone's heart and the incarnation of Nara and Narayan Rishi in the form of human being. O personality of Godhead, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. So here he's saying one should offer their respectful obeisances unto that original Supreme Personality of Godhead, who stays in everyone's heart as Paramatma and who is the witness. So in Bhagavad Gita, it is said, in everyone's heart, the analogy is given like on the stem, there are two birds sitting. Similarly, in our heart, there are two souls sitting. One is Jivatma and another is Paramatma. So Jivatma is our self and Paramatma is that super soul. So Paramatma is the witness in everyone's heart, but he will be awaiting for the Jivatma to turn towards that Paramatma, and he will always be waiting like the person or the father who has lost his child. And when that child revives his relationship with that Paramatma, then he will shower his unlimited blessings. So here one should offer the respectful obeisances unto that Paramatma and also the incarnation of Nara and Narayana Rishi in the form of human being. So as we can see in the picture, Nara and Narayana are the Krishna and Arjuna in this Kali Yuga. So currently it is said that Narayan Narayan Rishis are training future Manus in the place of Badrikashrama. So what we know as the Badrinath. So at that place, currently, Nara and Narayan Rishi are training the future Manus. So, O personality of Godhead, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Naraya Haraye Namaha. Namo Markata Shyama Vapuse Digata Shriye Keshavaya Namastubhyam Namaste Pita Vasase. My Lord, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you who are dressed in yellow garments, whose body hue resembles the Markata gem, and who have full control over the goddess of fortune. O my Lord Keshava, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. So here there are three attributes discussed. One is one who is in dressed in yellow garments. As we know, Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna is always wearing Pita Vasa. So he is always dressed in yellow garments. And how his bodily effulgence is. So his bodily effulgence is like Markata Shyama. So the Markata gem, which will be bluish, light bluish shining. So that is how Lord's body's effulgence is, or Lord Bali's color is. And who is having full control over the goddess of fortune. So in this world, everyone will be running behind the money. So that is an expansion of Mother Lakshmi. But that Mother Lakshmi is always serving that Supreme Lord who is seated as Narayana in the Vaikuntha. So that person, I offer my respectful obeisances, who is dressed in the yellow garments and whose body hue resembles that Markata gem, and who has full control over the goddess of fortune. Oh, my Lord Keshava, I offer my respectful obeisances unto you. Tvam sarva varada pumsam varenya varadarshabha ataste shreyase dhiraha padarenum upasate. O most exalted and worshipable Lord, best of those who bestow benediction, you can fulfill the desires of everyone, and therefore who are sober for their own welfare worship the dust of your lotus feet. So here it is said like best of those who bestow benediction. So that Supreme Lord who is the best of the people who bestow benediction, because all the demigods, other devatas, they also give benedictions. But because the demigods are temporary, their benedictions are also temporary. If we take an example, when Ravana was performing the austerities, and when he had asked the boon to Lord Brahma to become immortal, so that is an eternal benediction. Then at that point, Brahma says, how can I give you eternal, because I myself have death. So I am temporary, I have death. How I can give you that benediction to that eternal thing? So it is not possible. That is how it is said. So any devata who is the sub-creation of Lord Brahma, when Lord Brahma itself himself is temporary, then what to speak of other devatas? So here, this Lord who bestows the best of the benedictions, so he can give that liberation which will be eternal. And you can fulfill the desires of everyone. Here it is not said that he can fulfill the desires of only devotees. It is said that Lord who can fulfill the desires of everyone. It could be devotees, non-devotees, or anyone. It could be animals or any living entity. So as we can see, So Lord has bestowed his mercy on Prahlad Maharaj. We have discussed in the last chapter, last canto. And next example is Dhruva. So Prahlad Maharaj had no material desire, but here Dhruva had a material desire. He wanted to have seated on that supreme personality, and he wanted to be greater than Brahma. So with that desire, he started to go to the forest. But with the mercy of Narada Muni, who meets him in between, he gives the process of worship to the Supreme Lord. But when Lord comes in front of him, all the material desires vanquished. But still, Lord fulfills his desire, giving that planet which is greater than the Brahmaloka. So he has given that Dhruvaloka. And he is, so here, based on that, we can understand Lord fulfills the desires of everyone. And with the example of Sudama, what we can understand, Sudama came to the place of Lord Krishna's palace. And he there, Lord Krishna welcomed and he hugged and he welcomed. He washed his feet. He has given all opulent food and he happily discussed. So at that point, desire of Sudama was not getting any material things, not to ask for any gold or such thing. His desire was to see and relish Lord Krishna. But Lord Krishna knows the inner intention of why Sudama is there, because he was suggested by his wife to meet Lord Krishna and get them out of their miserliness. So not miserliness, basically their poor condition. So Lord Krishna understands the desire of Sudama as well as his wife. So Sudama got his desire fulfilled by having association with the Supreme Lord personally, and Sudama's wife, by the time Sudama reached his home was fully opulent. So Lord fulfills the desire of everyone. And the last one, as we can see, Kubja, who was welcoming the Lord. So Kubja was not at all looking good. She is, as we can see, she is having that bend on her back. And when she sees Lord Krishna, she is like, she wants to apply that sandalwood pulp which is there in her hand. She applies that hand. She wants to hug and kiss Krishna. So at that point, Krishna bestows his mercy on Kubja. And later, she becomes a beautiful woman. So Lord fulfills the desires of everyone. As even we saw Gajendra Moksham, Lord fulfills the desire of even animals. And for their own welfare, they worship the dust of your lotus feet. And it is said, Akama sarva kamova moksha kama udaradihi tivrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusha param. So even if one has spiritual desires, the transcendental desires, akamaha, or if one has a material desire, sarva kamo, and if one needs liberation, moksha kama, so what they should do? So if you are having any desire, it could be spiritual, material, or you want to get liberated. So any desire if you have, what one should do? Tivrena bhakti yogena. One should perform devotional service with great force. Yajeta purusha param. To that personality of Godhead who is the Purusha Param, who is the Purushottama. And this is how one will be getting into the devotional service. So for any desire, one should perform devotional service. But when one has that maturity in the devotional service, what his consciousness should be is explained by Lord Chaitanya. Nadanam najanam nasundarim kavitam vadegadisha kamaye mama janmani janmanishware bhavatat bhakti rahitukitvayi. So in the previous verse, if you have any material, spiritual liberation, if you want whatever, it is said, you perform devotional service, but once anyone starts devotional service, then by default they will get detached to all the material things. Then what they don't desire, they do not desire any material wealth, material followers, or their partners, or their activities described in flowery language. And what they want, they want mama janmani janmanishware, in this life or life after life, bhavatat bhaktir ahaituki tvayi. So ahaituki, that unmotivated, what they want, unmotivated bhakti, bhavatat bhakti, devotional service to that particular bhagavan, to that lord. So here in these two verses, if one is having desire, they should perform bhakti, but when one performs bhakti, he will get detached to the material things, and he will be just asking that devotional service. It is not even mentioned that liberation, it is mentioned as that devotional service to that Supreme Personality of Godhead. Anvavartanta yam devaha shrishya tatpada padmayoh sprahayanta ivamodam bhagavan me prasidatam. All the demigods as well as the goddess of fortune engage in the service of his lotus feet. Indeed, they respect the fragrance of those lotus feet. May the Supreme Personality of Godhead be pleased with me. So this should be one's consciousness. So all the demigods, as we can see in the top picture, all the demigods are representatives of that Supreme Personality of Godhead to perform their prescribed duties in managing this material universe. So Indra is to take care and give rains, one, and Varuna and Agni, as we all know, rains and fire. So all the demigods, they are having their respectful positions. So one should understand, and all the demigods engage in the service of his lotus feet, and as well as the goddess of fortune. So Mother Lakshmi is also engaged in the service of his lotus feet. So in Brahma Samhita, it is said like thousands of Lakshmis, they worship the Lord Narayana or Lord Govinda, the primeval Lord Govinda. And indeed, they respect the fragrance of the lotus feet. So in this material world, if we need to have some fragrance, we need to go and smell some fragrant flower. But in the spiritual world, flower, it does not need a flower to get fragrance. The Lord's feet itself is the source of all fragrance. And may that Supreme Personality of Godhead be pleased with me. एतैर् मन्त्रैर् हि श्रीकेशम् आवाहन पुरस्कृतम् अर्चये श्रद्धया युक्तः पाद्योपसर्पण पसर्पणादिभिः. कश्यप मुनि कंटिन्यूड बाय चैंटिंग ऑल दीज मंत्रास. सो टिल नाउ व्हाट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, सो वन शुड ऑफर द रेस्पेक्टफुल ओबेसेंसेस अनटू दैट सुप्रीम लॉर्ड इन ऑल दिस थिंकिंग ऑल दीज पास्ट टाइम्स. So by chanting all these mantras, welcoming the Supreme Personality of Godhead with faith and devotion. So the faith is the most important thing, and with devotion, offering him items of worship such as padya and argya. Padya is offering water to wash the feet of the Lord, and argya is offering the water to the Lord. And one should worship Keshava Hrishikesha, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So with all the mantras, whatever we discussed in the earlier verses, one should chant all these mantras, and welcoming the Supreme Lord with great faith and devotion, one should wash the feet of the Lord and offer him required argya. And later, what one should do? अर्चित्वा गंधमाल्यादैः पयसा स्नपयेद्विभुं वस्त्रोपविताभरणा पाद्योपसर्पणा पसर्पणैस्ततः गंधधूपादिभिश्चार्चयेद् द्वादशाक्षर विद्यया. सो द्वादशाक्षर विद्यया इन द बिगिनिंग वन द डिवोटी शुड चैंट द्वादशाक्षर मंत्र. सो व्हाट इज द द्वादशाक्षर मंत्र? ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय. सो दिस इज द द्वादशाक्षर मंत्र. एंड व्हाट शुड डू? वन शुड ऑफर फ्लावर गार्लैंड्स इनसेंस एंड सो ऑन. After worshipping the Lord in this way, one should bathe the Lord with milk and dress him with proper garments. So one should welcome the Lord, one should offer flower garlands, one should offer incense, and later one should bathe the Lord with milk and dress him properly with proper garments and a sacred thread and ornaments. So one should give or one should put the ornaments to that Supreme Lord and give a sacred thread. After offering water to wash the feet of the Lord's feet, Padya, one should again worship the Lord with fragrant flowers, incense and paraphernalia. So after bathing the Lord, again one should worship that Lord with fragrant flowers, incense and other paraphernalia. So this is the way to perform. Shritam payasi naivedyam shalyannam vibhave sati sasarpi sagudam datva juhuyan mula vidyaya. So if one can afford to, one should offer the deity fine rice boiled in milk with clarified butter and molasses. While chanting the same original mantra, one should offer all this into the fire. So one should chant that original mantra, Dwadashakshara mantra, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. By chanting this mantra, one should offer deity fine rice boiled in milk. So it is said that one should offer payasa, which is having butter. Molasses is the juice came out of the sugar cane. So one should offer that payasam, which is having rice, boiled clarified butter and the juice of sugar cane. While chanting the Dwadashakshara mantra, one should offer this into the fire, because he is the representative of Supreme Lord. He will be taking the offerings and he will be handing it over to that Supreme Lord, because that is his prescribed duty. निवेदितं तद्भक्ताया दध्याद् भुञ्जितवा स्वयं दत्वा चमनं अर्चित्वा ताम्बूलं च निवेदयत्. सो वन शुड ऑफर ऑल द प्रसाद टू द वैष्णवा और ऑफर हिम सम ऑफ द प्रसाद एंड टेक सम वनसेल्फ. सो कुक ऑपुलेंट और सफिशिएंट प्रसादम, ऑफर सम टू द लॉर्ड एंड offer it into the fire, and whatever is the remaining, please offer it to the Vaishnavas, and whatever is remaining, then they can take some oneself. And after that, one should offer deity that achamana, and later tambulam, that then betel nut, and after that one should again worship that Supreme Lord. So one should prepare the delicious meals prepared with milk, and they should offer it to Lord, they should offer it in the fire, they should offer it to Vaishnavas, and they can take something, whatever is remaining, themselves. And after that they should offer the achamana, as and later they can offer a betel nut. They should offer a betel nut and worshiping the Lord. जपेत् अष्टोत्तरशतं स्तुवीता स्तुतिभिः प्रभुं कृत्वा प्रदक्षिणं भूमौ प्रणम्ये दण्डवन् मुढा. देयर आफ्टर वन शुड साइलेंटली जपेत् अष्टोत्तरशतं, one should silently murmur the mantra 108 times, Ashtotra Shatam, and offer prayers to the Lord for his glorification. So whatever the prayers which we have discussed earlier were the prayers in the glorification of that Supreme Lord. So one should do japa of this Ashtotra Shatam, and one should remember the glorification of the Lord. Then one should circumambulate Pradakshinam of the Lord, and finally, with great delight and satisfaction, Pranamye Dandavan, one should offer obeisances falling straight like a rod. Dandavat, that is why we say Dandavat Pranam. So it means I am surrendering to you. So when we do this kind of Dandavat, if someone is hitting from us from back, we will not be able to recognize. That is how one should offer their respectful obeisances, because they should forget everything and they should offer. So they should not understand what is happening in and around them. And later, Kritva Sirasi Tacche Sham Devam Udvasayet Tataha Gavyavaran Bhoja Yedvipran Payasena Yadochitam. After touching to one's head all the flowers and water offered to the deity. So till this time, we have offered many ingredients to that Supreme Lord. So we have offered flowers, incense, and lot of items. So after performing all these activities, one should touch that flowers to the head and water offered to the deity, and one should throw them into the sacred place. The flowers, whatever is offered to the Lord, we should not put in a dustbin. That is why in every temple, we will have a separate place for Nirmalayam. So all the flowers which have been offered should be disposed properly. Then one should feed at least two brahmanas with sweet rice. So payasena vipran. So vipran means learned brahmanas. One should feed at least two brahmanas with sweet rice. Bunjitatair anugnataha sheshata sheshama sabhajitaha brahmacharyata tadratyam swobhute pratamehani snata suchiryadoktena vidina susamahitaha payasasnapayitvarchedyavadvritasamarpanam. So after doing all this, after taking the flowers and putting that properly into the Nirmalayam, now what one should do? One should perfectly honor the respectful brahmanas one has fed. So they should give all their respects to the brahmanas who took the honored the prasadam. And then after taking their permission, one should take prasada with his friends and relatives. So whoever were that vipras, the learned brahmanas who have honored to come to your home and honored that prasada, first only they should be fed. And after they are happy, then one needs to take their permission. And after that, one should take the remnants, whatever is remaining prasada, with his friends and relatives. And for that night, one should observe strict celibacy. And in the next morning, after bathing again, with purity and attention, one should bath the deity of Vishnu with milk and worship him with according to the methods formerly stated in detail. So one should respect the Brahmana. One should make the Brahmana sufficiently happy with the offerings. And after he is satisfied, then with their permission, we should take the remaining with our friends and relatives. We can take that. And on that day or all these days, one should observe strict celibacy. And day after day, in the next day morning, one should again take bath. One should again, with purity and with great faith and devotion, they should bath the deity of Vishnu with milk, because this is Prayavarta. Milk takes the priority with milk and worship him according to the methods formerly stated in detail. So this is how the priorata is performed, and this will be continued for the 12 days, whatever is the days which we have discussed in the beginning of this session. So here we will stop today's session. So today we have discussed, like, after Aditi's request to Kashyapa Muni asking what is that process to continue in devotional service and by which we can please the Supreme Lord and we can restore our original positions, Kashyapa Muni, he advises Mother Aditi with the instructions. So he gives all the instructions on what are the things one should do while performing Payuvrata. So we will have a review, or we will have again a recap tomorrow, so that we will be again context. So now, if anyone has any questions, we can discuss. So we have one thing in chat window. Dhruvaji was a great devotee. He performed devotional service. Still, why he desired for material benediction after performing devotional service? A devotee always seeks spiritual benefit. So, Mataji, is it like after that, or is it like before that? Because prior to meeting that Supreme Lord, he was a small kid, and at that point he was desiring the material benefit. But when his mother directed him to go to forest and perform the austerity to please Supreme Lord Vishnu, Narayana, at that point Narada Muni met, and he has given the instructions on to perform the austerity to please Supreme Lord. So gradually he became devotee, and during the process of his meditation he became devotee, and when Lord appeared, he did not ask for his material benefactions. Instead, he was glorifying the Lord. But because Lord is so merciful, he remembers why Dhruva Maharaj started his journey to the forest and the austerity. Lord himself has given that benediction. Dhruva Maharaj later did not ask. It was like Lord has given that benediction. Dhruva Maharaj was satisfied after seeing the Lord. Okay, so if we have no more questions, yeah, we will continue with our japa session. Thank you all for joining in. Tomorrow we will complete this chapter of the process of executing Payavrata. Thank you all. Hare Krishna. Om Tat Sat Sri Krishna Arpanamastu.